Hello everyone, this is FKMEC official YouTube channel. My name is Engineer Farman Khan. Today in this video, I have to tell you about how to design a domestic water cooler for a specific temperature to cool the drinking water. So this is a water cooler which we design now, and it will have the two best features. Number first, it will cool water very quickly in a short time, and number two, this water cooler will consume very less electrical power. So if you want to learn this specific calculation for this water cooler, then watch this video till to end. So this is a special project of my students, and in this project we have used a compressor of 1/4 horsepower, a condenser of 1/3 horsepower, and also a evaporator of 1/4 horsepower. How we will do this all project, let's see with us. So these are my students, and first of all we will calculate the evaporator. Here the volumetric capacity of this tank is about 15 liter if you will calculate the above parameters. So first of all, we have to measure a one length of this evaporator coil, and then we will multiply the total numbers of lengths in this evaporator coil. So the first length is about, if I show you very closely from the camera, so this is about 31 inch, which is equal to the 2 feet and 7 inch. So now we shall count the total numbers of the evaporator lengths, and then we will multiply into 31 inch. So here this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So total 17 numbers of length. One circular length is 31 inch, and the total numbers of lengths are 17 multiply 31 inch is equal to 527 inches, and then to convert it to feet, so just divide the 527 and 12, so the length of the evaporator will be 44 feet. So the evaporator coil length is 44 feet and its dia is 1/4. Okay, now the one straight length of the condenser tube is 8 inch. It is about 8 inch. One straight length of the condenser tube is 8 inch. Okay, and the each U band connect with two lengths, so each U band is equal to 16 inch. So now we will count all the U bands. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Okay, so total U bands are 29, and now we will multiply 29 with 16 inch. Here the two single straight lengths with each U band is 16 inch, and the total numbers of U bands are 29, and it will multiply with 16 inch and then convert it to feet, so total feet 38.6, which is about 39 feet of length of this condenser. Now we will adjust the pressure drop inside the capillary tube from 150 psi to 180 psi, and for this purpose I have already put a charging pin at the one end of the capillary tube. But first of all, we will measure a length of this capillary tube. So the total length of this capillary tube is about it is 4 inches less than 10 feet. Okay, so 9 feet and 8 inches. Okay, so this is a capillary tube of 031, and the length of this capillary tube is 9 feet and 8 inches. So here the size of this capillary tube is not so much important. The important thing is a pressure drop inside the capillary tube. Now I will show you that how to check the pressure drop of this capillary tube. So I will check the pressure drop of this capillary tube with the compressor in the same unit. Now I connected the charging hose with the charging pin, so you can see the pressure drop on the high pressure gauge, and it is about 150. It is about 150. So I think it should be 160 or 165 psi, but it's okay. Later I will make a heat exchanger from capillary tube. So now this is, I have made a heat exchanger of capillary tube on a suction line. So then the pressure drop of this capillary tube will slightly increase more with this heat exchanging. Now my student is joining the capillary tube with the inlet of evaporator, and it should be noted that the capillary tube should be inserted from 1 inch to 2 inch inside the evaporator tube. So after joining the capillary tube, now the vacuum process is in progress, and I will hold the video now until to 20 minutes when the vacuum is completed. Now after completing the vacuum with a very good and a standard type vacuum pump, now I will charge the R134A refrigerant in this water cooler, and then I will show you the further result of this water cooler. So now the final result of this water cooler is ready, and as you see that the various thermometers which I placed at different stages in the cycle. So the first thermometer, and this shows the discharge line temperature, and as you see it is about 58 degrees centigrade. Okay, so 58 degrees centigrade is the temperature at inlet of the condenser, and after circulation through this condenser the refrigerant temperature at outlet is 37.5. so what is the difference between inlet and outlet? 58 minus 37, it is equal to 22 degrees. So it means the total 22 degrees Celsius temperature is decreasing throughout the condenser. Now I will show you the cooling coil temperature, and this is the evaporator inlet temperature, which is about minus 2.5 degree centigrade, but you should note that this is a temperature of this evaporator coil without any thermopore insulation. Okay, while the temperature at evaporator outlet is 21.5 degree centigrade. Okay, so the difference between evaporating inlet and outlet is minus 3 and the 21, so plus 24 degrees. So the total temperature difference in inlet of evaporator and at outlet of evaporator is 24 degrees Celsius. So here this is the side glass at suction line, and that's why the liquid refrigerant comes to compressor, because there is no water inside the tank. So now if you will see that what is the suction pressure of the refrigerant R134A, so you can see on the pressure gauge the suction pressure is about 15 psi. It is about 15 psi, so the suction pressure is a little bit higher than a refrigerator. Okay, now what is the consuming current in ampere? So as you see on the multimeter, the current is 0.6 ampere, which is very low power consumption. So I hope this video will be helpful to you. Then please like this video and share this with your other friends, and don't forget to subscribe this YouTube channel. Thank you very, very much.